Hello everyone and welcome. Sometimes in Java projects we see a file named pom.xml, and if we don't know what is this file about and what's its purpose, then this tutorial is for you, because in this video I'm going to explain pom.xml, what is its purpose and how it works. So the pom.xml file is basically present in the root directory of a Maven based project. When we create a project, we usually select the packaging or build tool. Let's say when we create a new Spring Boot application from Spring Initializer, we have option as Maven project or Gradle project. These two both are for dependency management. Since we are talking about pom.xml, the relevant thing is Maven project. When we create a Java project as Maven, then we'll find the pom.xml file in the root directory. Earlier in Maven version 1 and 2, the name was project.xml, and from Maven 3, the name of this file is pom.xml. Let's check a sample pom.xml file. This is a pom.xml file when I created a Spring Boot application having Maven as build tool. So here, as you can see, this file contains the information about the project and the configuration details, what version of Java is used, and what version of Spring is used, and what will be the name of the application when we build jar or var, etc. So this is the main purpose and most useful part of the pom.xml file. You don't need to add jar manually to project, which used to be done in earlier application of Java. So now you just need to add what version of a specific library you want to use. Maven will automatically download the dependency from their Maven central server and will put it on the Maven home or M2 home you have configured. In my computer, I have configured Maven home on my system environment. Now let's see how the dependency management work in Maven. For that, I have opened a website named Maven Central. This is a website called Maven repository now, and I want to add JUnit library on my Spring Boot application. So I went to this website, selected the library and selected a specific version which I want to add. And as you can see, for Maven we have this sample code. So I'm copying this dependency and adding it to my pom.xml file under the root dependency tag and pasting it here. And now, as you can see, a new sync button is appeared here, because this version of JUnit is not present in my Maven home. So when I click on this, it is sending request to server to download the dependency. As you can see in the lower left corner of the window, it's saying resolving dependency of mail. Mail is the name of this application, and importing Maven, and now it's done. So now the error is also gone. Now the JUnit dependency of this specific version is present on my Maven home. So you don't need to manually add the jar file or worry about the version. So this specific version will be used for this project of JUnit. So this is how pom.xml actually manages the dependency of your application without giving you any hassle. And it also uses this information to build the var or jar file when you need them. So this is very useful. Another option is Gradle, which is pretty much similar. The idea is pretty much similar. So if we recap, the pom.xml is actually an XML file which contains the information about the project, manages the dependency, and provide build information. If you find this video useful or want more similar content, please encourage me by subscribing to my channel or by liking my video. And thank you so much for watching. If you have any feedback, please feel free to comment down below. And once again, don't forget to subscribe.